Hi, I'm Dr Janelle Sinclair, and in today's video we're going to discuss the natural antidepressant 5-HTP and the effective 5-HTP dosage for depression. I'm going to outline the right way to take 5-HTP, covering what it is, how much to take, when to take it, common side effects and how to avoid them, as well as drug interactions. If you haven't met me before, I'm Dr. Janelle Sinclair. I've got a PhD in biochemistry and I'm a natural medicine practitioner who specialises in mental health. And on this YouTube channel, you'll find practical videos discussing effective and safe natural therapies for depression and anxiety. Make sure you stick around to the end to find out about how long it normally takes to respond to 5-HTP. And what to do if you're already on an antidepressant medication. And if you're new here, consider subscribing and hit that bell button so you're notified about our new weekly videos. So let's begin and discuss a little bit about 5-HTP, what it is and what it's used for. 5-HTP stands for 5-hydroxytryptophan. It's naturally produced by the body and is made from the amino acid tryptophan. 5-HTP converts into the happy and calming neurotransmitter serotonin, and then serotonin is converted into melatonin, the sleep hormone. Because 5-HTP can increase both serotonin and melatonin levels in the body, that's why it's effective for both depression and insomnia. Small studies suggest that 5-HTP is actually as effective as standard antidepressant medications. 5-HTP has actually been used clinically for over 50 years, and the conditions that it's commonly used for include depression, anxiety, insomnia, fibromyalgia, headaches, and obesity. This video is about using 5-HTP for depression, so let's discuss the effective dose, when to take it, and how to avoid side effects now. 5-HTP is a simple supplement that can be purchased from the pharmacy, a health store, or just online. It is produced commercially by extracting it from the seeds of the African plant Griffonia simplicifolia. It is absorbed very well when taken orally, with 70% of the dose getting into your bloodstream. But before I go on and tell you how much 5-HTP to take for depression, if you're on antidepressant medication, I want you to promise me that you'll watch the next section on drug interactions, okay? Good. Well, the most common starting dose of 5-HTP for depression is 50 milligrams three times a day, usually at breakfast, lunch, and dinner. If you struggle with poor sleep, you may want to take that third dose before bed. And if you don't see an improvement in your mood after 2 weeks on that 50 milligram at three times a day at that dose, I want you to increase it to 100 milligrams three times a day. Some studies have used up to 250 milligrams three times a day, so that's safe, but it isn't a common practice. Also keep in mind that 5-HTP can really help reduce anxiety in doses up to about 150 milligrams a day. But at doses above 225 milligrams per day, it seems to worsen anxiety symptoms. 5-HTP can be taken either on an empty stomach or with meals. It really doesn't matter. Some people think that the other amino acids or protein in food will interfere with the uptake of 5-HTP in the brain. However, this actually isn't the case. 5-HTP easily crosses the blood-brain barrier, as it does not require a transport molecule to do this. One side effect of 5-HTP is that if you take it with a meal, it helps to increase your satiety. That is, you feel fuller quicker. So 5-HTP can actually be helpful for weight management and appetite control. Now that's a great side effect, isn't it? 5-HTP does have some other side effects, but these can actually be avoided or reduced if you follow some simple guidelines. The most common side effects include nausea, stomach upsets, headaches, insomnia, and palpitations. The severity of these side effects are usually dose dependent and are also related to how quickly the doses are increased. So start on a lower dose of 50 milligrams 3 times a day to avoid this. And if you're someone that is very sensitive to supplements in general, or if you get the side effects straight after starting the 5-HTP, then I'd recommend that you just start on 50 milligrams once a day and slowly work up from there. 5-HTP doesn't work for everyone, but do stick around until the end of the video and I'll discuss some other options for you. So is this all making sense to you? Give me a yes in the comment section below if it is. Or maybe you'd like to share your experience with 5-HTP. Now let's move on to consider any potential interactions between 5-HTP and medications. The interaction we need to worry about is combining 5-HTP with medications that also increase serotonin in the body. Because both the 5-HTP and the medications increase serotonin, there is a risk of serotonin syndrome and cerebral vasoconstrictive disorders. These medications include tramadol, a common painkiller, and antidepressant medications including SSRIs, tricyclics, and atypical antidepressants. You may also know these as citalopram, fluoxetine, paroxetine, sertraline, amitriptyline, or clomipramine. If you're unsure, check with your doctor. While some people take 5-HTP while they're reducing their antidepressant medication, I suggest that you only do this with the guidance of your health practitioner. So if you're already on an antidepressant medication, I don't think 5-HTP is the best option for you. There are a lot of other natural supplements for depression that can be used at the same time that you're taking the antidepressant medication. I'll discuss this further just in a moment, but first I promised you that I'd tell you how long it takes for most people to respond to 5-HTP. Well, 5-HTP actually works fast, and a large majority of people experience some improvement in as little as 3 to 14 days. If you don't feel lift within 2 weeks, increase the 5-HTP dose as I suggested earlier. And if after 6 weeks on 5-HTP you haven't experienced an improvement, I would personally recommend that you consider a different approach. Rather than just taking lots of different natural supplements for depression on a trial and error basis, my approach is to rule out and then treat naturally any underlying biological causes for depression or anxiety. For example, if we find that you have a nutrient deficiency that can cause depression, we can use a mineral or a vitamin to treat it. If you find an hormonal imbalance, herbs and natural hormones can be used. If a blood sugar imbalance or a gut dysbiosis is found, we can use diet and supplements to treat these factors. I discuss these imbalances and how to treat them a lot on this YouTube channel. If you find that 5-HTP doesn't work for you, or you're already on an antidepressant medication, or you just want a more personalised approach, then I suggest that you learn more about the biological causes of depression and anxiety. And I've actually created a playlist on that topic here. There's an overview video and also information on vitamin D deficiency, zinc deficiency, and gut health. And I'll be adding more videos to this over time. And if you found this video helpful, like it and share it with a friend. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.